Hello, everybody, and welcome. I'm Brian DeMars for ChannelFireball.com, and today I'm going to be doing an Hour of Devastation, Hour of Devastation Amonkhet League Draft. I'm preparing for Grand Prix Indianapolis, which is sealed and draft, so I've been spending the past week working on my limited game. So let's get to looking at this first pack here. It's not great. There's nothing I'm super happy to take first pick here, but I guess notable cards in this pack, the Blood Water Entity. And the Quenchable Thirst. Both fine cards, not great first picks. The Entity is a stronger card in general, but I think the Quenchable Thirst is just sort of a more flexible card. It's hard to predict that we'll be able to be blue-red right off the bat, so take a nice blue card here. So this second pack, the two standout cards are red cards, a Fervent Paincaster, and a Struggle to Survive. Outside of that, I mean, Sandblast is a fine card. Nothing to write home about. There's some deserts. I think deserts get taken maybe a little bit too high. The payoff isn't... There aren't enough big payoffs to really make it worth picking deserts too early. I try and get them out of, you know, kind of weaker packs where I'm not giving up much. The Striped Riverwinder is powerful, but these come around pretty late. They are a 7 drop. I'm going to go with the Struggle. It's just a very good removal spell. It's kind of like a Terminate as you get later in the game because it can kill nearly anything. So I'm going to take the Struggle. I'm not married to this Quenchable Thirst either. I mean, I'd move off it if there was something else. So this pack is also pretty weak. We haven't seen a lot of super strong cards here. I think this is the kind of pack where you could take a desert. There isn't one in either of the colors that... Well, there's a Painland desert, but I tend to like this one the least. Outside of counting for a desert, it's kind of just like an island that deals damage to you when you tap it for mana, for blue. I actually think the strongest card in this pack is either the Aven of Enduring Hope or the Ruin Rat. I've been pretty impressed with the Aven. It's a pretty good 5-drop in the scheme of 5-drops you could play. So, in the spirit of taking the best card in the pack, I think I'm just going to take this Aven. So, this pack... The rare is fine, not great. I have no green yet. I have a red card, a white card, and a blue card. The Vizier of the True is pretty powerful. The Aven is still a solid pick. I could take a desert. Their red is not looking particularly open, so maybe I can splash the Struggle. I think I'm going to go with the Vizier of the True here. Maybe look to be blue white or blue or white red. So it looks like moving into white may have been a smart move, as the Sunscorched Champion appears to be the sort of overall most powerful card in the pack. Frontline Devastator is a fine card, but red doesn't feel open, and this isn't really a sign that red is open, but a fifth pick Sunscourge Champion certainly bodes well for being in white, so let's take that, and then can sort of figure out what the secondary color might be. So maybe red is a little bit more open than I thought. A lot of good red cards in this pack. Haven't seen a ton of blue either. I could take another Aven, but really want more 5-drops. I'm tempted to take maybe the Firebrand Archer here. I don't have a ton of experience with Inferno Jet, but doesn't seem like the kind of card that this white-red deck would want. I'm not super, super aggressive here. I'm going to take the 2-drop and just get on the board with the 2-drop. I like this as far as 2-drops go. It will deal some extra damage over the course of the game. So maybe red is a good color to be in. I have, as far as white and red cards, the another Inferno Jet, a Thorned Moloch, and a Mummy. I don't really have zombie synergies, and if I'm going into white-red, that's not really a good zombie kind of color. So I think it's probably the Moloch here or the Inferno Jet. I'm just going to go with the cheap creature here and try and get this deck kind of aggressive if I can. So this pack is a white desert or a Dutiful Servants, a Desert of the True or a Dutiful Servants. I like Dutiful Servants more than most people do, but with that being said, I still think this is probably a good time to get a desert. So I'm going to take the desert. Another sort of weak pack. Best card in this pack is probably the 2-drop or the Sidewinder Naga. I'm going to take the Blur of Blades. I would like to get this deck aggressive. I have some Spells Matter cards with the Thorned Moloch and the Firebrand Archer. So I'll take the Blur of Blades. It's good in a spell-heavy deck. Good in a Prowess deck. There's only one card in here that I can really play, so I'm going to take the Saving Grace. With that being said, I like Saving Grace quite a bit. I think it's pretty good. Kindled Fury is good in an aggressive deck. I'm giving up a hostile desert, but I only have the one desert, so Kindled Fury has a pretty good chance of making it into my actual deck. I don't like Steadfast Sentinel as a card. I think it's too low impact, so I'll take the Crash in case I want to be like a spell-heavy deck, another Kindled Fury, a Graven Dominator, and a Mountain. So we'll see where this goes. I definitely need more creatures. I need creatures on curve. I only have one 2-drop. But I like the fact that I have a couple of 3-drops, a 4-drop, and a 5-drop. My curve isn't too heavy anywhere. These Kindled Furies are cheap. So I'm going to prioritize cheap red and white creatures, particularly 2 and 3-drops, over the next couple of packs, unless the cards that I'm choosing between are just like really, like in general, powerful. So let's take a look at what this pack has to offer, and unfortunately the answer is not much. There's a Blur of Blades or a Sandblast or a Desert, and I have no Deserts Matter cards so far. And the Deserts Matter cards tend to matter less in the aggressive decks than in the more controlling decks. A lot of the tacked on Deserts Matter abilities tend to be life gain related. There's a Camel that gains lifelink, there's an Arrest that gains 3 life, that kind of thing. So there is the Ceridon that taps things down when it attacks, but I'm not going to really prioritize. I need to prioritize playables, so I think Sandblast is just going to be the best cards. I already have a Blur of Blades, it's kind of a conditional thing. I already have 2 Kindled Furies. I don't really want to. There's nothing here worth branching out into a different color. The Sifter Worm is a great card, but not my color. So I'm just going to take the Sandblast. So this pack, the best card in this pack is probably the Oasis Ritualist or the Vizier of the Anointed. Both fairly strong cards. I'm not going to be able to play either of those. I'm not going to dip into blue when I've already invested so much into being red-white. Pretty much just need it to come together or not at this point. Pretty deeply invested. With that being said, Dauntless Aven is very good, and Frontline Devastator is a card that I wouldn't mind picking one up at some point, but I think Dauntless Aven is just a better card in general. And I'd like to... I have a Vizier of the True, so these red-white decks tend to be pretty good if you can get like an Exert theme going, so I'm going to take the Flyer with the Exert synergies. So this pack, another Dauntless Aven, or a bad 2-drop, or a cycling 5-4. I really wish that this was a good 2-drop here, but it isn't. It's just pretty vanilla. As the draft goes on, I might have to make picks where I pick a Defiant Kenra over a Dauntless Aven, but for now, I'm going to take the Dauntless Aven because it's going to be a good card in my deck, and I know I'm going to play it. So this pack also has some options. Bad 2-drop, a Desert, a Wrath, a lot of picks here. I feel like my deck is not a very good Wrath deck. I'm just going to be wrathing away all my own stuff. I really want a 2-drop, but the Chef at Dunes is a pretty powerful little late game card, and I already have a Desert. So I'm going to take the Chef at Dunes. I think now, there's a lot of late Obelisk Spiders. I wish I was in black-green. This pack very good for black-green. I think this pack is where I'm going to actually just bite the bullet here and take the bad 2-drop. I need 2-drops for my deck. So this is kind of a pick where I think the Frontline Devastator is a much better card, but I need 2-drops to make my deck work. My deck's not going to do much if I don't have 2-drops. So this is kind of a weird rare. I've had this played against me to great effect. I played an Hour of Devastation and my opponent returned all their creatures to their hand, which was pretty awesome. I don't have really comes into play abilities outside of a few life gain creatures here. So I don't think Leave to Chance is really what I want, even though it's kind of a cool rare. I'm probably going to take the Mummy Parapet. It's just a better Defiant Kenra, since I could theoretically make a zombie and pump it at some point. It'll make the cut over the Kenra pretty much no matter what. So we'll take the Mummy there. Looks like the pick here will be another Vizier of the True. I'm really hoping that I'll be able to get some Exert creatures. I'm kind of sad that I didn't get any of the 3-1 Exert to be indestructible creature, because it would be really good with all these Dauntless Avens and now a second Vizier of the True, but there just aren't any around for me to pick. So, I mean, this is a good card to be so late in the pack. I feel like we may be in the right colors, but just not getting particularly paid off for being in red-white. It's possible we shouldn't be in red-white, though. Maybe we should have been blue-white. The Aven is just still a fine card. I'm happy to take an Aven here. So it's between Saving Grace and Blur of Blades. I could see Saving Grace being pretty good in here. I'd rather have 2 Saving Grace than 2 Blur of Blades, I think. Maybe I'd rather have 2 Blur of Blades if I want to be aggressive. I think the second Blur of Blades might be where I want to be. Another Desert here to fuel up the Chef at Dunes. Maybe get multiple activations out of the Chef at Dunes. So Struggle is really more of a 3-drop. Feel good about the 4s and the 5s locked up. 2 Dauntless Aven and a Sunscourge Champion and a Moloch are good 3s and 2 decent removal spells. Take the Defiant Kenra, we passed it the first time around and it wheeled, which is kind of nice. Probably will not play Crash here. I mean, Farm shouldn't be... I get that maybe there's not a blue-white player, but this is just a better Sandblast. I'll take a Crash for the sideboard. We're already at 20 playables, so... there's the Leave. I can board this in against maybe a Wrath deck, and that Sidewinder Naga probably shouldn't be in that pack either. Alright, so what do I have here? A ton of good green cards, and a Drakehaven that I can't play, and a Stir the Sands. So I'll take the 2 mana removal spell every time. But let's think about what this deck sort of needs here, where it's lacking while we wait. Other people are going to take a while to make their pick anyway. Really, I want good twos. I'd like to not have to play all these Defiant Kenras. I like most of the other cards that I have going on in this deck, so besides for my weak twos, my threes are pretty good. So there's a Blinding Mummy or a Vizier of Remedies. And not much else. I do need the twos, and the mummy is a zombie for the mummy paramount, and vice versa. I'm going to take the Blinding Mummy here. There's significantly less minus one counters matter cards with Hour of Devastation than there were in... Triple Amonkhet, so I think the upside of the mummy outweighs the upside of the vizier. Well, this is exactly what I was hoping for. I was hoping to just snap off three gust walkers in a row, but not always going to be the case. But very happy to get a third pick one. If we remember correctly, pack one, I moved into white a little bit later in the draft, so. White was kind of open coming from this direction, so worth noting. There's a True Heart Twins, a Mighty Leap, or a Brute Strength. I think the True Heart Twins is kind of where I want to be. I sort of have some built-in exert synergies going on. So I'm going to prioritize any card with exert that's white or red from this point forward. I now have enough playables to make my deck, so I'm going to be looking to upgrade. So there's a Trial of Solidarity. I have 15 creatures, so I'll probably be fairly creature heavy. This card should be pretty good. I don't have any cartouche yet, but I passed a red one at one point. So there's an Evolving Wilds, a Minotaur Shore Shot, and a Pursue Glory, or a Supply Caravan. I think the Shore Shot is likely enough to make my deck that I'll pick it here over the Evolving Wilds. Would have been nice to get maybe one more cheap exert creature than I did. Which is kind of sad. At the beginning of combat on your turn, you may have target creature you control get +2/+0 and gain haste if you do sacrifice at the beginning of the next end step. Well, this is kind of an unfortunate pack since there is nothing here for me. I'm going to take the desert and add it to my sideboard. Also kind of a weak pack. Someone will be happy to get a Colossal Peed and a Naga Oracle, but I'll take the Resolve. It's maybe better than some of the other cards in my deck. I guess I'll take this Supply Caravan. It's the only card in my color. So I'm kind of looking to see how many creatures I have and where they fall on the curve here. Ooh, that's a nice one. That'll probably make the cut. So I have 1, 2, 3. Only four exert creatures, which is like not a ton. I don't think that'll make the cut. A fling, put that in my sideboard. Probably don't need double Blur of Blades. I think I'm going to cut the Trueheart Twins. One of these Defiant Kinras can probably go to the board. Mighty Leap is probably the one I'd be most likely to play. So, I think this is a pretty decent red-white deck. I mean, I have no rares, but I have a low-to-the-ground curve. I should be able to win some games. I think this draft in general, the sort of thing that characterizes it for me is we started off with weak packs and the deck is sort of solid and cohesive, but it lacks high power level cards. It's just sort of a low curve with good tricks and some removal, which is fine. I mean, if you get that every time, you're doing something right, and so the law of averages will sort of come out, and sometimes you'll just have better cards, but it's not like I passed up on awesome things. Maybe green would have been better, but there really wasn't a green card to take out of the first pack. So this is, I've got it sort of whittled down to 23 cards here. Let's display, let's sort by converted mana cost. I think Juru's Resolve is probably better than Kindled Fury. So I think I picked a second Juru's Resolve later in the draft. Or maybe I'm mistaken, I only got the one. So I guess I will play the Kindled Fury. I didn't take the second one. I have the Return All My Creatures spell on the sideboard. Let's add basics. I need way more mountains than this. Let's go to 7. Let's go to 8 mountains. Why is it? Oh, it always adds a forest and an island. How lucky. Okay, hold on. Let's move the forest and the island to the sideboard. And then let's get some of these plains out of here. I want 17 lands. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 white sources. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 for 17. That seems pretty good. And then this is 23 spells with a low curve. Let's just make sure I'm not leaving anything out that I really should want. Maybe these Trueheart Twins deserve a place in the deck. I don't think I'm going to start the Trueheart Twins. I have 14 creatures, 9 lands. That is, maybe I can cut a spell. What is the worst spell? So I want both of the 1 mana spells. Blur of Blades is maybe a little bit loose. Mighty Leap is great. Compulsory Rest is great. Sandblast is fine. Farm is fine. Trial is fine. And Struggle is great. So I think the Blur of Blades is probably the weakest one. So I'm going to add Blur of Blades to my sideboard. I can board it in against decks with a lot of X1s. I'm going to put the True Heart Twins in the main deck. And I'm going to play it like this. So thanks for tuning in and for the draft portion. And I'll be right back with round one. Thanks for tuning in. Hello, welcome to round one of this Hour of Devastation draft. I won the die roll, so I'm going to play first. I have a red-white deck. This hand seems fine, so I'm going to keep it. Lead off with a mountain. And pass the turn. See what we're up against here. Hopefully draw more spells. That's a decent one. So I only have one 2-drop. I'm going to drop it onto the battlefield and pass the turn. So going to play a 3-drop next turn, pretty much no matter what. And attack. So two combat tricks, that's kind of nice. If I need to, I can cycle Juru's Resolve. So let's attack first, make sure my stops are set properly. Appears I have one on my second main phase, which is good. So get in for two. And second main phase. I think I'll play the flyer. And I'll pass. So that's kind of annoying. That will pretty much brick my Vizier, being that it's a 1/4. And none of my combat tricks will push me past my mountain. And let's go to combat. Attack with the Aven. Aven can untap itself. And second main phase, I'll drop the Minotaur Sure Shot, and I can leave up Juru's Resolve. Kind of good news, at least the Sure Shot can attack into this Seer. It's very awkward right now that I have two combat tricks that do not... Ooh, what is this? At the beginning of each player's end step, Enchanted Player puts the top X cards of his or her library into his or her graveyard, where X is the number of cards put into that graveyard from anywhere this turn. Okay. Wow, so I'll get milled, and then I'll get milled again. So drew another Aven, so I think the play is going to be pre-combat, I'll attack with Aven and Sure Shot, I'll untap the Sure Shot, and I'll play another Aven if my opponent doesn't block, so we'll see what happens. So let's go to combat. I'm going to untap the Aven. And we'll see if my opponent wants any piece of blocking. So So it does not look like my opponent is blocking, so I'll pump. Go to second main phase and play another Aven. So I'm getting milled, and then I'll get milled again. So a bunch of cards got milled. And then Fraying Sanity will mill me again. All spells, I'll probably draw land. This is a pretty powerful combo. I do have 23 cards left in my library, which is kind of nice. Hopefully my opponent doesn't play anything that will mess up my flyers too much, because they're pretty important. I do feel nice that the Vizier is covering me from Splendid Agony. Okay. Oh wow, okay. So that was a pretty big turn, and I'm getting milled pretty fast. So what is the play here? Attack in the air. What happens if I attack with everything? If I attack with everything, the Seeker will go on the Vizier, and the Minotaur will go on the Hollow One. So I think the play is that I will attack with the two Avens and the Sure Shot, then I can pump the Sure Shot, Kindled Fury the Sure Shot, to first strike down the Hollow One, and then I can play a Mummy Parapet. And the Vizier has to stay home. So let's go to combat. I'm going to untap the Aven again. And I'll untap the other Aven. So if my opponent has the desert card that keeps creatures tapped, both of my Avens will be able to be untapped. So I'm anticipating a block there. Kindled Fury. And I'll pump. So the Sure Shot will first strike down the Hollow One. My opponent will take 4. And then second main phase, I'll play Mummy Parapet. Or Paramount, sorry. I get milled for a card. So opponent cycles. They probably could have cycled on their turn. Oh, I guess the cycling doesn't affect... This is only cards go to my graveyard. And I win. Okay. So that was game one. Let's take a look at the sideboard and what I can sort of do. My opponent had a lot of high toughness creatures. So these combat tricks were not actually very good. I think I want all my cheap beatdown things. The trial seems good. These sort of unconditional removal spells are good. So what can I do to be faster or better? I can play another 2-drop. The Blur of Blades seem good against the high toughness blockers. And maybe they get some more damage in. Maybe I just want Pursue Glory. So I added another creature and a Pursue Glory in place of the Resolve and the Kindled Fury, and I'm gonna... Maybe I could board out a 5-drop, too, for another cheap creature. Board out the Aven and bring in another 2-drop. And hopefully, if the 2-drops get kind of bricked early, I'll be able to play one of my +2/+0 Anthem spells to push through a ton of damage and win combat. So it doesn't have a white mana, but it has a 2-drop on the draw. I think I'm going to run it. Hopefully draw a white source, because I have a lot of white sources in the deck. So keep. Not what I was hoping for at all. The troubles are compounded, but I can still draw planes off the top and it'll be like nothing bad ever happened. You may cast non-land cards with cycling from your graveyard. Okay, so I can get Unburdened from the graveyard. That's pretty powerful. All right, in business. Play the creature pre-combat to troll the guy who always says I shouldn't do it in my comments. Haha, and bash. So I can F6. I think I'm going to discard the twins and a land just so I can keep my pressure up. There's a Desert of the True. I'll play my Mummy. Play a land. And attack. I'll untap the Aven. Cool if I drew my other, Yeah, if I draw my Mummy Paramount, would be a good draw. So I think I just want to get this Duskwalker in play. I'm going to wait till after combat in case I get bounced here. I can attack with everything. I'll untap this one so I don't get beat up by the thing that keeps everything tapped down. Second main phase. Okay, that's Gus Walker. I think I'm just going to hold this cycling land to cycle it later on if I need to. So I'm glad I held it now, because I'd rather keep this Aven in my hand than discard it and have a random fifth land in play. Combat. Attack with everybody. No exert. This pushes through 4. Next turn, hopefully I'll be able to exert the Gust Walker and untap it with the Dauntless Aven, which will be pretty sweet. It was one of the synergies I was hoping to have more of in my deck when I was drafting it and picked up the second Dauntless Aven. I was definitely looking for it, it just didn't really come up. Alright, and we beat a blue-black mill deck, so sweet. Didn't even get to do my combo. See you for round 2 in a minute. Hello, welcome back to round 2 of this draft. I got round 1 against a blue-black mill deck. I'm playing red-white. So I won the die roll, and I'm going to play first. And I definitely want to keep this. This hand seems pretty good. So keep. So I'll play my desert into play tapped and ship the turn. Going to curve out with probably the Mummy Parapet here into the 3 drop, into hopefully the 4 drop. Well, now I'll probably play the Dauntless Aven. I guess it'll depend on what. I'm playing the Mummy over the Vizier just because I don't want to get wind up in a weird situation against a 1 power creature. Plus I could draw my Blinding Mummy, I guess. So now I have some choices. I'm just going to offer the trade here. My opponent may not block. Alright, that was cool. They didn't block. I didn't want them to block. So second main phase, I'm going to get this flyer down. I want to be the beat down here. Next turn, I'll probably play the Vizier of the True. I am not trading with that. So I'm going to play my 4-drop here, because if I draw a land, I can play 2 3-drops next turn. Just the most efficient way to get this card into play. And I'm going to attack first. I guess I'll untap the Aven to play around the enchantment that keeps a creature tapped down. My opponent doesn't have a desert yet. I'm not intending on blocking. I'll get my 4-drop deployed. Hopefully the best card for me to draw next turn is a land. Not blocking. Racing. So, I'm going to bring the beats with everybody, exert to tap down the Firebrand Archer, and untap the Vizier of the True. So Vizier of the True, we'll tap the Firebrand Archer. Dauntless Aven will untap the Vizier of the True. Opponent taking some damage. Second main phase, we'll play Sunscourge Champion and ship the turn. Kind of rough for my opponent missing a land drop, but drew another land, so it's okay for them. But I'm sure their plan of not trading with the mummy and trying to race, they weren't happy to miss a fourth land drop there. It's going to put them in kind of a tight spot, but I've now missed my fifth land drop, so, you know, we'll see. So let's see if they have... I'm sure they must have something to find. Yeah, a Skirmisher. That's a good one to find there. It's cheap. And they probably have no attacks because of the 2-3. So my attack is going to be... to alpha my opponent. Tap down the... tap down the 2-4, I think. Or maybe I should tap down a 2. No, I want to tap down the 2-4, I believe. And then I'm probably just going to play another Aven post-combat. I could sandblast whatever my opponent blocks the Vizier with. Or if they put a double block on the champion. We'll have to find out what they're going to do. But my attack is going to be to shove with everything here. If my opponent makes me use the sandblast in combat, attack and exert, and regular attack. So the Vizier will tap down the 2-4. And the Aven will untap the Vizier. See what the blocks look like. So I could sandblast the archer. Or I could just play another Aven. I kind of want to sandblast the Vizier next turn, so I'll just take the trade. And then I'll play the second Aven. That's two flyers in the air there. Threatening lethal. And hopefully I don't get Splendid Agonied here. That'd be bad. Okay, so they don't have an answer to the flyer, so let's go to sideboard. One thing, a lot of four toughness blockers, the format really does slow down quite a bit. So my opponent did have a lot of cheap creatures, so I think these kind of Kindled Fury, Blur of Blades cards might be good. And maybe I don't want the Trial, since it looked like just a bunch of things that we're going to trade. I'm not trying to beat my way through bigger things. Board out one of the Avens. Bring in another 2-drop. I've got my two removal, hard removal spells, the Sandblast and the Farm. Maybe Saving Grace would be better than Blur of Blades. I could see that being a kind of a blowout card in this matchup with a bunch of little creatures. Be really good on the Vizier of the True. It's kind of cheap. So that's 40. Board out a Trial. I boarded in another 2-drop. I think this all looks pretty fine. Let's try it like this. So I'm going to be on the draw this time. I don't think this is really a hand that I can keep even on the draw. It doesn't pressure at all. So I'm going to mulligan. This hand's kind of worse, but I don't want to go to 5. I wish I would have kept the other one. It's not usual that a hand is bad enough to mulligan and you get a hand that's worse. But I'll keep and I'll look for a mountain, I guess. I gotta put this on top because I want to draw a mountain this game. Put it on top. So hopefully we don't get rushed too hard out of the gate. But I do have a compulsory rest. And I have a Saving Grace to put on a Vizier of Truth, which seems like a pretty decent thing to do. So my opponent led off with a dual land, about as good of a start as you can have. Shocking, I drew a mountain. Play it. Hope I draw my Blood Moon. Would really wreck my opponent here. I drew a creature. Decent one at that. Let's get it on the floor. opponent getting the beatdown on. Oh, wow. Okay. So, do I want to attack here? I think I do. Play the Vizier of the True here. I'm willing to take a hit from the Celebrant. Here, it's not going to exert. No, maybe it will exert. And if it exerts, I'll just take the 8 and go to 10. My opponent will have a tapped Celebrant, and I'll be able to get on the board here. Question is, do I want to trade with the Celebrant, or do I just want to take the damage and like double spell next turn? I think I'm just going to block the Celebrant here. And my opponent probably should have exerted for some. Well, if my opponent exerts, I wouldn't block, I would take 8. Opponent having some trouble with drawing lands this game. I think I just want to attack. And if my opponent, my opponent's not going to block. Play another creature. The next turn I can. I don't have great targets for this removal right now. I'd rather just play this and save this removal for things that I care about. I should be able to get ahead in the races here. Got some good removal and some good tricks that I'll be able to leave up. So I think I'm going to play my Defiant Kenra. All damage dealt to you and permanents you control is dealt to enchanted creature instead. So I'm going to attack with both. My opponent will probably try and trade here. I'll drop the struggle onto the Kenra, and then it'll be able to hold off my opponent's creatures. Main phase. Let's go to combat. Hopefully my opponent isn't unsummoning me. That would be kind of a disaster. But there was a reason to play this pre-combat. I want to put the Saving Grace on it if my opponent doesn't have exactly Unsummon there. So just a regular attack. Let me read this one more time. When it enters the battlefield, all damage that would be dealt this turn to you and permanents you control is dealt to enchanted creature instead. So we'll target the Kenra. A prowess, and suddenly things are looking very good for me as I have three creatures that are better than my opponent's two and two removal spells in hand that I can cast both of them next turn. Maybe I should have started Saving Grace. This card seems awesome. It is when it works out like that, for sure. Just have a 2/5. That's a bad start for my opponent. So I think here what I'm going to do is I'm going to compulsory rest. The Kenra. Get a prowess. Then I'll go to combat. I'm going to attack with my team. Attack. Attack and exert. And attack. I'll tap down Firebrand Archers. Tag my opponent for a bunch of damage. And then second main phase, I'll play another flyer. And I won't have the Vizier next turn, but I'll have a removal spell. And I guess I technically don't even need to use a removal spell unless my opponent tries to double block. So I drew a desert. So go to combat. Attack. 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 Use the Aven to untap the 2/5, so it can block, I suppose. So I take some damage. If my opponent doesn't block, I can win the game because I'll get a prowess trigger. So let's see if my opponent wants any piece of blocking here. So they didn't block. So I'll shoot there. And that should do it. Okay, two wins with this very medium red-white deck. See you for the finals. Hopefully I can get that trophy. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the finals of this Hour of Devastation draft. I'm playing Red White, 2-0, trying to get a trophy. Got a nice little curve out hand here, so I'm going to keep it. Oh, looks like Moto. Oh, maybe Moto is going to be nice to me, not crash. That'd be cool. Alright. Like, stuttered there for a second. Sputtered around and didn't want to work. So another red deck. I drew another Vizier of the True. So, let's see how aggressive my opponent can get here. It's a good one. Very good one in this archetype. If it attacks, I might even consider trading with it. Because I know that my Blinding Mummy is not very good. It's only got maybe one or two uses total in my entire deck. I'd bite a combat trick here to get it out of my opponent's hand. I don't want the combat trick trading with these better creatures. And I'm on the draw. Oh, wow. Okay. So I'm going to be pretty far behind this game. Wrong card. And I'm not going to attack. It's going to be a tough one. Yikes. So I think I kind of have to. Trade this mummy. With this Kenra, even though I don't want to. I have to somehow stabilize this board. If I draw like a good 2-drop next turn. Because it kind of stinks. I have no... no real recourse but to do this here. I'm not racing, so it's super mana inefficient, but... to be fair, on the draw against a very good rare, like, this deck is not... if I can't be the beatdown, what am I doing with my life, you know? One of my two 3-3 flying gain 3 angels would be great. Yeah, just taking a ton of damage. That's a good start. I'm still behind, and I still have to deal with this Earthshaker Kenra buyback that's coming when my opponent hits 6. So probably in the next turn or two, it's happening and I'm in trouble. So I have to be the control here, because my opponent is clearly the beatdown, and I'm not a very good control deck. I just really don't see much hope of getting out of this game alive. But I can sideboard into a better deck for this particular matchup. So hopefully I can get the sideboarded games if this winds up not working out for me. I think I'm going to chance it. And hope my opponent doesn't draw land and kill me. I'll leave up the Sandblast next turn. I got to get something deployed somewhere at some point. You know, I realize it's a risk. See, they didn't have it. Oh, but I'm still super dead. So, I guess that's got to happen. I think I have to hope my opponent doesn't draw the, thing again. I can keep this alive. Yeah, opponent's like, I don't care about that. That doesn't do anything. Oh, maybe it's like a brute strength or something to just kill me. Yeah, okay. Alright, I die. Oh, why did they... Oh, I see. Alright, so I get to be on the play. And I need to be better in the aggro. So the Vizier of the True is pretty bad. I'm just going to bring in random 2 drops here. The Trial is not great. I'll bring in Blur of Blades. Sandblast is a little bit too expensive. So I'll bring in... another Kindled Fury. I'm going to board out the True Heart Twins and bring in Supply Caravan. I'm going to board out Mighty Leap, bring in Saving Grace. So I have 5 cheap tricks. A bunch of 2 drops. I like the Dauntless Avens. I actively hope to draw the champion. The other Avens are fine. And then I have sort of 2 kind of good removal spells here. Yeah, let's try it like that. Well, yeah, let's try it like this. See where this gets me. So I'm going to play first, yes. I'm going to keep. Plains go. Hoping to draw enough lands to get these Aven of Enduring Hopes onto the board. Would love, like, a 2-drop would be the best possible thing. The best 2-drop would be Duskwalker, which is very good with Dauntless Aven. So I'm hoping to draw a Duskwalker. Gustwalker, which I haven't drawn a ton of this tournament. Okay, my opponent must have been away from their computer for a second, but they're back. And it's my opponent's beginning of combat, so I'm going to F6. Wow, I was just talking about how great this card was. Pass the turn. That was a great draw. Now I kind of just want to draw some lands. I should ask for things more often. Main phase, I'm going to go to combat. And I'll exert and take the damage here. Okay, that's a good start for this aggro matchup when your opponent cycles. Okay. They also acknowledge how important the tempo is in this matchup. Play this, and I've got the Kindled Fury trick up. I will probably take the block here. If my opponent wants to use a removal spell, so be it. Oh wow, this could be great if my opponent doesn't have anything. This could be a great turn for me if my opponent doesn't have like a blur of blades or, yeah, that's unfortunate. I needed to not say blur of blades because I've like asked for everything I've ever wanted this game and gotten it. I think I want a land. I gave my opponent the Blur of the Blades, so give me the land would be great. Thank you. This is unreal. I'm going to do this at the Grand Prix. Just regular attack there. I'm hoping this Kindled Fury will at some point line up with First Strike taking down this Defiant Kenra with flying and +1/+1. Removal spell would be great too. Haven't drawn one yet, but have several in my deck. Ooh, that's a spicy one. So I think the first order of business is to cycle this. Let's see what I get. That's kind of cute. So I think I'm just going to regular attack with both creatures. And see what happens here. Probably won't be thrilled about this. Well, that was the worst thing that could happen. So hopefully, I'm not even going to say it. Oh, is it happening? It's not happening. Awkward. This is a pretty darn good follow-up with that giant creature there. Awkward that I drew a removal spell for a good creature, and that was the one that my opponent had there. Draw like Zhruj Resolve here. Let's cycle this. So that's a destraw. It's awkward, whatever I do here. I think I'm just going to bash with if my Aven dies from something, if I attack with this creature, I'm still not lethal. But if my opponent, so I think I'm just going to attack with both. I can't really chump here because I'm not in a winning position. If I lose, if my opponent has like a burn spell or a pump spell, I lose. I don't know exactly what the... I can beat, like, Earthshaker Kenra, though. Or a haste creature. I think I'm dead. Yeah, if I would have left this back and chumped, I get in for six. But I wasn't beating a removal spell if I did. So it's so hard to say, because if I just attack with this creature, and my opponent has, like, a removal spell, then I can't win anymore. I'm just, like, I have to double chump block and I can't present lethal. This way, if they have one removal spell here, they take two, they go to five, and then I can swing back for five with a removal spell for a blocker. So I took a line that beats some things. I couldn't beat a burn spell or anything that deals three to the face with this line. So I'm going to die and lose the match, which, hats off to my opponent. Their deck was, like, pretty good. Like, I had a good draw that game, and they beat me fair and square. So, yeah, decisions and choices. They influence the outcome of the game, but I don't hate the line that I took there. It's something that maybe, if you want to discuss it in the comments, would be interested to hear your take on it, but I think it's close either way. Didn't get that 3-0, but went 2-1. I thought my deck was a little bit below average as far as power level, but I thought it was a good draft overall. I think, given what I had to work with, I made reasonable choices and reasonable plays throughout the tournament. So I feel pretty good about a 2-1 with a deck that I think is average to below average. That's really all you can hope for when you're playing a lot of Magic. You know, you can hope for the broken cards, but that's going to happen when it's going to happen. Most of the time, you're going to play with, you know, with what you get. And that was what I had. And 2-1 with that deck, I think, is pretty decent. So I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in. And I would like to encourage you to leave comments. And if you like the video, hit the like button up there. And I do respond to the comments in the comment section. There were a lot of good ones for last week's Hour of Devastation sealed video. There were some good discussions about some of the card selections and talking about different strategies with that sealed build. So I'd be interested if you watched the draft, if you would have made some different picks maybe, if you thought different things were more open and not open. Maybe I missed something. But that's always fun stuff to talk about, and I'm always down to talk about it in the comments. So I encourage you to leave them. And last but not least, if you enjoy the videos and the content, be sure to subscribe to the channel Fireball YouTube channel. There's a ton of great content being produced on there. LSV does videos, Reed Duke, Owen, just awesome content providers and really great players. It's a really good way to keep a heads up or get an advantage over, you know, players, whether you're going to a Grand Prix or a PPTQ or just playing Friday Night Magic drafts and constructed. It's a great way to see what the best are doing, what the pros are doing, and to learn from it and to get some insights. So I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in, and I hope you have a great week.